Hi, it's Jeff.
And Denise from Mousesteps.com.
And this is episode number 109.
109. Where does the week go?
I know. Mousesteps Weekly.
Sponsored by Theme Park Connection in Orlando, Florida.
And they are on the way back from California right now with some more new goodies.
I know. They probably got rid of some, too.
So. I'm sure that's true.
And PixieVacations.com. It's a great time to think about fall and winter travel for the holidays at Walt Disney World and Universal Studios as well. So definitely give them a call or check out their website.
Also, Maple Leaf Tickets, our official ticket agency, the best deals on tickets in town. Check them out for theme park tickets.
Yep.
So anyway, on with the show. We're going to start with the Polynesian, Disney's Polynesian Resort. You can see there's a big scrim here at the entrance where they're going to put the new Polynesian Village sign.
Right, the Polynesian
Village. Well, it'll actually be like a waterfall, according to the concept art. We'll see more of that soon.
And it really has changed quite a lot since about 6 weeks ago when we were here to dine at Ohana.
Right.
Maybe even a little less time, but things are happening so fast now.
This is my favorite area now, actually.
Because outside, it has a waterfall.
It's the last vestige. Yes, there is still a waterfall at the Polynesian, and you can still see these guys, these tikis. I love seeing them.
It's nice when you can see something that's familiar, because right now there isn't as much that's familiar anymore about the resort.
As we're about to see, yeah, as you walk in, the familiar waterfall, unfortunately, the smell, the biggest shock to me was there's absolutely no smell in there, and I'm so used to having that Polynesian smell when I walk.
I hope they bring it back.
They can truck it in. Somehow truck it in. So this is some concept art of the new Polynesian Village all around. This will be the new lobby, which you'll see is much more open. No big waterfall, but they'll have a little waterfall there. And that's what I mentioned before. It looks like it's a sort of a waterfall.
It is a waterfall. It will have some waterfalls.
There will be
but
many
it will
waterfalls.
Not, it will not be the one that we know and love.
Right, that's true. And a look at the check-in area. So, and now the back of the lobby itself is walled off. There's walls all around where the former waterfall used to be. But the doors in the back that would lead out towards the pool are also blocked off right now because they're doing major construction out there.
By a lot, I mean, the floral department probably has been going. Horticulture.
Oh, yeah, horticultural loves this. Keeps them very busy. Yeah, there's...
There's not very many ways to get around in this area, and they're going to be closing off the pool also. I believe that's this month.
Here's a little more concept art, just what the new entranceways to the new, I think those are the DVC buildings.
I'm actually not sure on that one.
So, and this is where the stores used to be. That was, what was the name of that store?
That was the Weiland Gallery.
That's right. Weiland Gallery was there, and there was a shop over there to the left.
I hope he gets to stay that tiki with the drum, because, again, one of the little familiar pieces of the resort still here.
Right. Now, to the left would have been the waterfall. And then you could have normally walked all the way around. Straight ahead would have been where the kids area is. And then if you took a left, then you'd just go back out the front door. But now it's just Donald and Daisy. It has sort of a dead end there. And then this shop
boutique
has remained, the boutique unchanged.
I believe they've moved a little bit of the merchandise from Trader Jack's upstairs, because that is closed. That shop is closed
right
now.
And there's a quick look at Captain Cook's, or at least the entrance to it, which has been relocated to the cafeteria. It should be opening soon in the new location, wherever that is.
Right, it's in the cast cafeteria right now, and Trader Sam's will be on the right hand side here.
Right, and this is the location that used to be the arcade,
Mona Mickey's.
Mona Mickey's, which actually long ago was at a completely different
place. Next to the Tangaroa Terrace.
Next to the Tangaroa Terrace. But as you can see, here is a picture of Oa there, who I hear will be a big part of the new Trader Sam's. This is the location that Trader Sam's will be once it's done next year.
Trader Sam's Grog Grotto.
Grog Grotto, correct. So it looks very, I think that, if done well, will be a great addition to the Polynesian, absolutely.
I agree. And I, up until now, I think that they are not going to be having an arcade, which is surprising, but that's what I've heard so far.
Right. And you can see outside here, this whole area where the wall is, that most of that is where Trader Sam's Grog Grotto will be. Now we're going to take a walk over here where the old Captain Cook's was, I think Captain Cook's is still going to be in the same location as before.
I believe that too, and I read online, I believe on the Disney site, that it's supposed to reopen next month, but it didn't look like it was going to open
anytime soon. Well, they were actually working. I mean, we have another video of this where you hear natural sound, and you can hear all the cutting and the saws and the pounding. I mean, they are working full force to get that part opened. So,
But next month is coming quick. I know, only a little over a week away.
It seems they're behind on quite a bit. Now, as we were walking here, I noticed they were putting up this wall around the stream that used to lead to the pool. And this was the very last day you could get these shots, because when we came back later at night,
it was all walled off.
With a very nice scrim, actually. So they're,
scrim
makers are kept very busy with this project, too.
That's very sad to see much go.
It is sad. You know, we always enjoyed the peacefulness and hearing the stream, and we would stand on the bridge and all that. But, change happens, I guess.
And I think it will still be a beautiful resort once done. I'll just miss, seeing it the way it has been much for, since the 70s.
The 40-some years that we've been visiting the Poly. But I was glad that even though it was going away, I was glad we were able to see it on its last day. We've been very lucky.
We saw the waterfall on its last day. Oh, you mean the stream. I thought you meant the resort itself.
Yes, correct.
it's not the resort's last day.
No, but these things, these iconic elements, like the waterfall and this, for us, it was very fortunate that we happened to see them before they were closed away and taken out.
Now, the volcano pool, though, is not something that was part of our 70s and 80s experience, but that will be undergoing changes as well, starting very, very soon.
Right. There used to be a different volcano pool with a slide that would go. You'd have to actually
Was there a volcano? I don't even remember.
Well, no, I take it back. It wasn't a volcano, but it was a waterfall slide, and you'd actually go up inside. You had to go through the waterfall, climb up the stairs, and go down this little slide. But at the time, as a kid, I loved it. I couldn't stop going
went to the quiet pool for some reason.
You wanted the quiet.
I wanted the quiet.
You're not a swimmer.
I'm not a big swimmer.
So we're taking a quick look at the DVC villas here over the lagoon.
Yeah, they're like Bora Bora style bungalows.
Here's a view looking out through the villa. This is the view you will see. I'm sure it'll be a lot better when you're actually in that
You'll be able to see more as opposed to just this little square that we can see. You'll be seeing probably the Magic Kingdom and the Grand Floridian.
And there is talks of having, and I really don't know if this is accurate, but there are talk of having little pools, sort of like a little wading pool, out in the front of these villas.
I read that online, and then I haven't read it since, so I don't know if they're going to have that or not. So I think it would be good. I mean, if you're going to spend that kind of money or that kind of DVC points,
it would be nice to have that. Absolutely, because this water here is not inhabitable. I mean, you are not allowed to go in the water.
Oh, what? You can't swim in it or anything. You can take a boat, but that's about it.
Right. So and now going back to the lobby of the Great Ceremonial House, this whole area is blocked off. As a matter of fact, once the pool is closed, it's going to be very difficult to get from one side of the resort to the other. It's already kind of difficult.
And they're missing a few letters here.
Yeah, can I have a lobby? Vanna,
can I give a
vowel. Right. So I don't know. I obviously that needs to be updated. I don't know what happened to those letters. So now we're going to take a look at the lobby upstairs, just a very quick look. As you can see, everything is blocked off up here as well, but it doesn't look bad. It looks like it's always been this way.
What, blocked off?
No, with these walls, with the walls.
That's what I mean, blocked off by the walls.
You wouldn't know it's blocked off if you didn't know there was something there before.
And we're coming up on the Kona Cafe, which is where we had breakfast.
And we're going to show some of that. This was a real highlight of our morning. We had the world-famous Tonga Toast.
But it's less expensive downstairs at Captain Cook's, so I would go there again next time.
Right, but this was Disneyland's birthday, July 17th. We wanted to celebrate with a little bit of style. So, of course, we had to have the Tonga Toast. And, oh boy. If you've never had it, you need to go there. And pressed Kona coffee.
Right, you can't get that at Captain Cook's, but you can get the Tonga Toast. So I'm just saying, to save a few bucks.
Let's not forget about the strawberry compote, too.
Well, that's one thing that's really different from downstairs. And it reminds me of the strawberry soup at Grand Floridian in the evenings.
And just what we did is we split. We ordered one Tonga Toast and a side of the breakfast potatoes.
And split it. We always split the Tonga Toast. It's a lot of food.
So, and this is a look upstairs. You could see that the gift shop there is closed. They do have a few little kiosks open.
And we just passed some of the Disney characters also on the wall just to brighten it up.
A lot of that. And I think that's great that at least they have that.
And also, I just want to mention, I don't know that I would stay here. The TripAdvisor reviews is still good, but I don't know that I would stay here right now. Four Seasons is just opening up.
There's just so much construction going on. And like you said, the Four Seasons, a matter of days, I guess
right.
that's a August comparable 3rd
is
property.
When that opens, right? That's going to be, you know, huge. So very right. excited about that.
Just take a year, maybe take a year off. And then when everything is done, come back and check out the Poly.
Well, we were told by a manager, March is supposed to be when the lobby opens. So that would probably be when I might come back to actually stay here.
Right. You can always visit, you know, to have dinner at Ohana.
Right.
Although I had just read Ohana has now taken away the salad, you know, that nice salad that starts
That's
your
the
meal.
One thing that
now,
I
now
liked.
let me clarify. It's not taken away. They don't give it to you unless you know about and ask for it. So if you know about it and ask for it, you can still get it. That's a true story.
I don't really like the food there. Unfortunately, it used to be one of my favorite restaurants, but, you know, things change.
We disagree. Again, a few episodes ago, we did a full review here on the show, and I love Ohana. I like the spices. I think the experience is great. You know, you disagree. That's okay.
I disagree.
That's okay. So now we're looking at more. This is actually where the monorail is, looking down the other half of the entranceway, and you can see they're clearing that. I'm not sure what's going to be put in there. But much clearing is happening everywhere, it seems.
Right. There's a lot of work going on here. And again, I read TripAdvisor reviews and they were fine. But
so we're going to
jump. Good, actually.
I don't mean to interrupt. We're just going to jump ahead. This is at the end of the night after we came back from the Magic Kingdom. We got off at the monorail at the Ticket and Transportation Center to check out the walking path. And you can see it's actually closed. There is an alternate route, and the alternate route takes you through some parking lots. And there's some dark areas. There's some well-lit areas. It's just different.
Well, it takes you through the front of the resort instead of through the resort. We really recommend the boat or the monorail right now instead, especially at night.
Right. And just to show you the area on the bridge when we returned that was not finished, now it has the scrim, so no more looking at the stream. Anyway, it is July 17th, which means it's Disneyland's 59th birthday. We couldn't be in California, but our tradition every year that we can't get to Disneyland is to celebrate it at the Magic Kingdom here at Walt Disney World.
Right.
And what we do is we go on all the opening day attractions from Disneyland, July 17th, 55, that are still in operation here at the Magic Kingdom at Disney World that are the same attraction. So one of them would be Peter Pan's Flight.
Right. There's not very many attractions
left for that. Not
anymore.
Not anymore. So I kind of tailored them to, like, the Diamond Horseshoe was actually opened. And the Golden Horseshoe was something that was opened for Disneyland opening day with Wally Bogue and all that. So we you know, it. With our theme, we were able to actually walk inside and sit in one of the boxes and check out the horseshoe.
It would be nice to go to Disneyland. I love Disneyland so much. So maybe next year for the 60th, that
right.
would be
well,
nice
we were
to
there.
See.
I was there for the 50th. We were both there together for the 55th. So I think it's only right that we be there for the 60th.
And there are the boxes, which aren't always open.
Right. That's why it was
here.
Kind of exciting to be able to actually go and sit in the box and check it out, get some pictures and things from up there.
And they had like carved turkey sandwiches and you know, the meals actually sounded pretty good.
Yeah, the menu did look very good. If we didn't have a reservation at our usual place,
Plaza,
we would have definitely tried it out. Plus, I think at this point, we were still full from our Tonga Toast.
Right. You can't have three meals when you're eating, like, two big ones.
So on opening day at Disneyland, they had a parade. So we watched the Festival of Fantasy Parade in keeping with our tradition. And it's not very much like the Disneyland parade, but it was wonderful. And it's the first time we saw this with the new music from Frozen added when Anna and Elsa come out.
It was, you know, we get the spot for the Fast Pass Plus, which actually is an excellent spot, and it never is too crowded. And it's nice to kind of to see them turn and then pass the castle.
Right. We go right where it comes right at you. But I actually kind of like this turn where it, you know, you get the best of both worlds. You get the parade coming at you. And then if you follow it, you have the beautiful castle in the background. So it's great for pictures and for the video and just for watching. I really like this location.
And it was nice that the rain held off because lately we've had a ton of rain in the afternoons. And very often this has not been going on.
You know, this really has become one of my top ever parades at the Magic Kingdom.
And I will say, for all the changes that have been made in the last few years at the Magic Kingdom, this is by far the best to me, you know, as far as quality and as far as something that I can do over and over again. Even mine train, I don't want to do over and over again all the time.
Right. This, I have yet to get sick of watching this parade. And sometimes it's even different. Like when it first opened, the ferries there, they were walking. Right. And now they sort of glide by. And this whole thing with Prince Philip doing his whole little... I don't know what you call it, battle with Maleficent. Mm-hmm. It's always, if you get the right spot, it's always fun to watch him do that. And I think you're going to see there goes the fire and here comes the sword. It's just fun to watch. The whole parade, all the colors, the music, everything about it, it really reminds me of a Kevin and Jody type parade that you would see at Disneyland.
Right. And I mean, I think this is the parade that Magic Kingdom has deserved for a long time and has not had. So there's
a fire-breathing, there is another fire-breathing dragon in town, I hear. Actually, we've seen the other fire-breathing dragon at Diagon Alley, but this one moves. So I say this one's a better fire-breathing dragon.
I think they're both good.
And let's not forget about Elliot from Pete's Dragon in the Main Street Electrical Parade. I don't think he breathes the fire, though.
No fire. And
it's a little smoke.
A little smoke, I think. And I was just going to mention, we do recommend getting Fast Pass Plus for this location. If you can get it, book it 2 months ahead if
Absolutely.
You were on
property. Fast Pass Plus. We love this area for Fast Pass Plus. Getting back to our Disneyland theme, the Walt Disney World Railroad, also an opening day Disneyland attraction. So, and here comes the train.
Right, we got on at Storybook Circus.
Right, and we did a Grand Circle tour. And while we were on the train, we did notice some new changes that we're going to see later. One of them being the Settler's Cabin has been reignited somewhat.
When you said that, I'm like, I don't remember any changes, but now I know what you're talking about. And here is Big Thunder Mountain, which we haven't ridden in quite some time.
I know. I think you're about ready to do that again. Also, we noticed that I couldn't get it from this side, but on the other side, they had the canoes from the canoe races. They used to actually have the canoe ride here at the Magic Kingdom on the Rivers of America.
But now the cast members every year have races for, I think it's like 2 or 3 days.
Right, very early in the morning. And have you ever done the Explorer canoes here?
No.
I know we've done them together at Disneyland.
I don't think I did a keelboat either.
That's very sad. But our next stop was the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train because Snow White's Scary Adventures, which is an opening day attraction, is no longer there at the Magic Kingdom.
And it was fun. I think it was the best ride we've had. So
yeah, it was great. We had it in the front row and we had so much fun. It was definitely, I think it was our best Mine Train ride yet.
And then we went to the Plaza Restaurant. As soon as our Fast Pass was over, we headed straight for dinner.
Right. And that's always a tradition on the 17th for us. We dine at the Plaza and this is a shot you took, beautiful shot out the window. This was the view. We had a nice window table.
Right. And I mean, we don't always get as good a table as we did as far as view. And here is, I got the Philly cheesesteak.
Yes, you always get the Philly cheesesteak. Sometimes you get it without the bun, though.
I change it up. Sometimes I don't get the fries. I'll get the mashed potatoes. So you can substitute.
Right. And I think I had the club sandwich. One of the real stars, though, is those fries. They're almost as good. And you know how we love the fries they have at Epcot over
mm-hmm. at England.
At the UK. So, boy, they were good. I always have a good meal, a good experience at the Plaza.
Right. We've always had excellent, excellent food here. And the fries, I don't like Disney fries overall, but these ones are very good.
So, of course, we had to wash it all down with dessert.
Wash it. I don't know how anybody can eat a whole one of these because these brownies are massive and we split it and we were still very full.
And it was actually very reasonable. It was only, I think it was $6 or $7.
No, I think it's like $5.49 or something. I mean, it's not a bad price for $5.99. It's a good deal.
Well, you could pay $15 to have ice cream out of Mickey's pants here.
That's true.
And this is actually Mickey's Kitchen Sink Sundae. Kind of expensive for what you get. I know you can get it also at other places.
Beaches and Cream, and I think it's supposed to be more expensive there. That's what I've heard.
Really? I know Disneyland has the best deal. I think it's $9.99 or $9.95, something like that. So if you fly to Disneyland, you can save the $5. Back to our opening day, Jungle Cruise, a Disneyland opening day attraction. We did manage to, this was actually our fourth Fast Pass. It was the first time we've ever been able to get more than the three.
You have to go to the kiosk to do it after you're done with your first three.
And it wasn't that bad of an experience doing the kiosk thing. They actually
some of the kiosks are very long lines.
Oh, it's the backside of water. And you must recognize that.
And he did this joke, but he missed one joke.
And the joke he missed is coming up. It's Trader Sam. I guess the boat was going so fast, he forgot to mention
Trader Sam. I have never seen that one. Missed.
But he had no time. There was no boats in front of him, and he had to, I guess he had to hurry up and get around to dock. So we did not, I mean, we know the Trader Sam joke.
I know, but it was very odd to not get that. And he was really good otherwise, really good.
So another Disneyland opening day attraction, the Mark Twain riverboat. This is the Liberty Belle here at the Magic Kingdom. And we rode it, and this was our big thing. We noticed the settler's cabin is
smoking.
It's not quite on fire. It used to be on fire in Disneyland. They actually had a settler that had a bow and arrow through him. So
a long time ago.
You had
it on a postcard.
Yeah.
A friend of ours mentioned it, and you went and checked the postcard, and that was the case.
So, you know, politically correctness and things like that, things have changed over the years. I don't know why they stopped having it be on fire. At one time, they rethemed it so it was like a moonshine thing at a still. The still caught on fire, and then you saw like a drunken moonshine guy out front. So you know, it's changed over the years.
Well, I think the fire part had to do with it was down for like a year, and then the gas pipe or whatever it was broke, or you know, like it would have cost a lot.
It's very suspicious that Disneyland's fire went out too, though.
Oh, I don't know. I'm just telling you what I read.
Might be a bit of a bogus.
Was it at the same time?
It was very close to the same time.
I mean, things change through the years, and for good and for bad, but at least there's a little smoke coming from the cabin. I guess that's a good thing.
And of course, the Haunted Mansion, which now it has a little bonus there. You have the Rapunzel Tower, but the trees keep growing and growing, so maybe eventually you will not see the Rapunzel Tower.
I know you can. I thought it was interesting because I took a picture of it with, you know, you've got
with the mansion,
and the
two different
the
worlds. They don't necessarily go together sometimes, but you know. What a great day. We had a really nice day at the Magic Kingdom celebrating the Disneyland. And like you said, maybe next year we'll actually be out there, although I'm sure we'll be out there for the D23
right. And
for maybe for Christmas and many other things. So
we'll just live there for a year. No, I'm kidding.
I don't know about that. This is one other thing that we spotted.
New to us because we're not over at the TTC very often.
But we saw the orange bird up there.
And I like the details in the sign. The orange bird sometimes is there, sometimes not. It changes.
Yeah,
frequently.
No, but it was really nice to see him. So there's never enough orange bird for me. But the reason that we're seeing all this is because we're actually leaving the Magic Kingdom. We've seen Wishes a lot lately. We're heading to Epcot because we love watching the Frozen fireworks that are held at the Hollywood Studios from Epcot.
Right, it's certainly much less crowded, and we're watching from China here, but next time we're going to try something different. We've watched already twice from China.
I don't think it's going to be easy to find a better spot, though. I love it over the American Adventure Pavilion. It's just amazing, so we'll have to go there many times this summer to see different different angles.
And thanks to Pixie Vacations, we have the contest still going on with them until, well, tonight. And then we'll announce it next week,
and we'll probably announce it earlier on the Facebook page.
Right.
Also, thanks to Maple Leaf Tickets, our official ticket agency, the best deals on tickets in town, and Theme Park Connection. They've been with us since the beginning, and we appreciate that very much. We will see everybody next week. Have a great week.
Have a great week.